Hello everyone, welcome you back to the channel Supply Chain Way. So in this video we are going to discuss in detail about warehouse processes, very specifically inbound, the activity of taking products into the stock, and outbound, the activity of processing an order and shipping the product to the customer. Okay, good. So let's get it started. But before we start, this is part of the series warehousing. The prerequisite videos to this video is given on the description. Please go through them and then you can view it. In case if that is difficult to retrieve, all you need to do is get into the channel, look for a playlist, Supply Chain Fundamentals. In that playlist, all the videos are kept in an order, so it will give you kind of a good continuity as you learn these topics. Okay, great. So let's get it started. So inbound, as I said, the scope of inbound starts from a truck is now reached the facility, that is the warehouse, till the products are in the inventory, that is, it is showing in your system as a stock, because that is now the organization's ownership. This entire thing is covered in inbound, and there are a lot of sub steps involved within this inbound. We are going to see it one by one. So moment a shipment reaches a facility, the first activity which happens is called a gate entry process. As I have said in the previous videos, the main gate security's role is one of the most understated role. I can fairly say this is the first impression for any visitor coming into the warehouse, number one. Number two, it is also the first activity which you do part of the inverting process. So what happens in a gate entry process? So the shipment has reached the gate. What the driver would do is get down the vehicle, take all the documentation and walk straight to the security to complete the gate entry process. So what this security has to do, part of the gate entry process, is first validate whether this shipment belongs to this warehouse, not even organization. Sometimes the organization will have multiple warehouses. So now they need to ensure whether this shipment belongs to this particular warehouse, number one. Number two, they need to ensure that whether there is an purchase order available for the product. It sounds like a very silly question, right? Why would a shipment turn to the warehouse if the organization didn't even issue a purchase order? Now that is where the scenario comes in of urgencies. In urgencies, what we happen, we tend to violate all the processes. So what the information would have been given to the supplier is, bring the material, we will take care of it. This all happens in day-to-day life. Is it the right thing to do? Absolutely no. The right thing to do from a supplier end is, before even a shipment comes to the warehouse, they need to send an ASN, advance shipment notification, at least 48 hours prior to the actual shipment reaching the facility to the organization, so that the invert team will know that these are the shipments coming tomorrow, day after. They can plan their processes. But unfortunately, most of the cases, it doesn't happen. But even ASN is not there. Without a purchase order, if a shipment is reaching your facility, it is actually really bad. And you need to revisit your processes. What kind of emergencies it may be. But most cases, as I said, it happens. So what happens? The part of the gate entry process, the security checks whether there is a PO. If there is no PO, what they do is they give a call to the buyer to tell that there is no PO. They ensure a PO is raised at that point of time, which is not the right process I am telling, but this is how that process will get rectified once a shipment is reached without a purchase order. So what you can just take for sure, without a purchase order, a gate entry process is not completed. The shipment cannot enter the warehouse. So the ideal process, a valid PO is available. And not just that, the third thing, the PO will have an estimated time when this has to be delivered, right? There will be a tolerance on that. Assume the shipment has to come next month. It has reached 30 days in ahead. The gate entry process can stop the shipment at the gate, and ask them to go back. But unfortunately, most cases, the gate entry personnel is not authorized to do that. But the best performing supply chains will ensure the gate entry process is handled efficiently by doing the three things. Check whether the shipment belongs to this warehouse. Check there is a valid PO. Check whether the estimated time of arrival is aligned with what is said by the organization to the supplier. If all good, we are ready to send the product in. Now, in few cases, part of the gate entry, the security personnel also does an external quality check of the products. In some cases, in most cases, they will just send the product inside and the inward team will take care of the other quality checks and other processes part of the inbound. Okay, so that closes the gate entry. So once this is completed, now receiving. So at this stage, if you remember in the previous video, we have seen dock is where the vehicle will go and get docked. Moment it is ready, the documents are handed over to the inbound team. There as well, a quick check of the documentation will be taken care, and then the inbound supervisor will give a go ahead for unloading the product. So while unloading the product itself, they will do a handling unit wise count. What do you mean by handling unit? For example, if the outer packing is a pallet, then that pallet is a handling unit. So your packing list, which comes along with this documentation, will read how many handling units, that is how many pallets are there in the shipment, that is validated while unloading itself. Okay, so that is also part of the receiving. Once everything is received, that means once everything is unloaded onto the staging area in inbound, you do a quality check. The quality sometimes will be split into two. There is something called as truck turnaround time. You know what that means? The time when a truck is docked onto the facility, you completed and you are giving a go ahead to the supplier. That is your truck turnaround time. That is one of a key metric. So, most cases, only the external checks are done part of the receiving and you sign on the proof of delivery and hand it over to the driver and the truck leaves. Rest of the processes happens after the vehicle is actually left the facility. But only catch here, in that case, you should have terms with your supplier that any kind of issues which surfaced out during the quality process after the vehicle is left can be reported back to the supplier within, say, 2 days or 3 days or 7 days. That could be a contract term between the organization and the supplier. Only in that case you can split that quality check into external check, which is done during unloading itself, and then the detail check you do after it. Okay, so this is again case to case basis, it varies. Okay, now that you have unloaded the product, you have counted the product, you also did a detailed check, the next activity which you do is sorting. Now here as well, there is a variation. Sometimes the sorting is done and quality is done parallelly, both. As the sorting is happening itself, quality check happens. But in some businesses, you completely do an inspection and then only sorting happens in a form and way in which you can put the product into the storage. In some cases, you do a sampling because you cannot check 100% of the product. You will check only a sample. In some cases, absolutely there won't be any quality check. Based on the field complaints, you actually raise a claim on the a supplier. So there are many variations here in terms of the quality norm. Okay, but as a standard process, after you complete gate entry, you do a receiving, you do a quality check, you sort the product according to where it should go, and then you do a tagging. What do you mean by tagging? You put some labels onto the product. It could be some additional labels, or this tag will tell which location this product should go to. But to have that kind of capability to tell upfront where this should go to, you should have a good WMS which can tell you which are all the empty locations, which type of locations will suit this product. That is called concepting. If your WMS has concepting ability, you can directly tag the product, put it into the location and just scan it. The system, the location of the product will get automatically updated into the system. But if you don't have that capability, you won't be able to do the location tagging on the product. You need to go to the location, put the product, and then only you will be able to come back to the system and update it. So there is a variation here. But again, as a general process, after sorting, you tag the product. After you tag the product, it is put away. Put away means you are now moving the product from the location, putting into the right shelf in the warehouse. That means now the product inward is completed. The product is in the inventory of the organization. That means it is in the books of the organization. Now, the time by which the product should be in the stock can be also different. Some organizations will tell, only after I complete everything, put the product, I will scan the product, scan the location. Now at that point of time, this product is available for sale. But there are few organizations, by the time you are completing quality check, that is your goods, receipts and inspection process, when you are finishing itself, they ensure these products are available for sale, because that scan of that this product quality check is completed will ensure there is available for sale. Okay, there are so many pros and cons of it. I'm not going to go to the detail here. Okay, but this is what I'm trying to tell here is there are ways in which you can customize your system in such a way when the product is available for sale. Okay, you can take care of that. Okay, now let me restate the process. The shipment arrived at the facility, you complete the gate entry process. You do a receiving, you do a quality check, you do a sorting, you do a tagging, you put the product into the storage. That completes the inbound process in the warehouse. Now getting back to the outbound process, it starts from receipt of an order. I call it as an order because sales order means only if the product is going to the customer. So let's call it as an order. It could be a sales order, it could be a delivery order, it could be a transfer order, it could be any order. Moment the order has come to the warehouse order processing team, okay, the order is processed and pick tags are generated. So what is a pick tag? Now in the inward process, you put that products into specific locations which will have a specific name, like 1A1, 1A2, 1A3. So pick tag will tell, now for this product, go to that particular location, pick this quantity, come back and bring it to the outbound staging area. This is what the outbound pick tag will read. Now what will happen? The picker will take that pick tag, go to that location, pick the product and bring it to the staging area. In this case, it is an outward staging area. Once the products are picked up for that order, you do a sorting. Why we do a sorting? Because there are two ways you can pick an order. One way, you take one order, go pick all the products part of the order, come back. In that case, you no need to sort it because that you are doing an order wise picking. But you can also do another form of picking, which is a batch picking, wherein all the orders which has come into a particular cutoff is grouped and pickers will pick one category of product and bring it to the staging area. At the staging area, you sort the products basis and order. I'll give an example. Assume this is a warehouse which takes care of home appliances. If you are doing order based picking, one customer has ordered one refrigerator, one TV. So what the picker will do, he goes to refrigerator storage area, pick one refrigerator, again goes to TV area, pick one TV, come back and then complete that order. In that case, there is no sorting, but most cases it doesn't happen that way. We consolidate all the orders received on a cutoff. Assume 1,000 orders are received. On the 1,000 orders, there are 100 refrigerators. Then there is one picker responsible for moving all the 100 refrigerators to the staging area. If there are 50 televisions, another picker will move all the 50 televisions to the staging area. Now, part of sorting, these individual products are put into specific order. So if there is an order which is one refrigerator alone, you keep that refrigerator separately. If there is one order with only two televisions, then you keep those two televisions separately. If there is one order with one refrigerator and one television, you pick them. So you do a sortation basis the order if you are doing a batch picking. Okay, there are some more hybrid way of picking that I will cover it on the further sessions within the warehousing. At this point of time, this is good enough to understand the process. Once the sorting is completed, you do a packaging. This could be in any form of external packing. Okay, once you completed packing, you do your invoicing and then you get the product shipped to the customer. there is a traditional practice of invoicing the customer and picking based on the invoice. This can pose a lot of issues in your warehouse, though it has been followed in many warehouses. That is not a right practice. As a warehouse consultant, I will never suggest invoicing and then doing a picking. It will have a huge implications. Like for example, you did an invoicing, but when you went in search of the product, that product is damaged, or there is a warehouse accounting issue, product accounting issue, that product is not available. You have to come back and re-account for everything. You need to even go back to the customer and tell, we already invoiced it, but we have to cancel this invoice. So many complications will come. Rather, it is always better you follow order processing, pick tag generation, product is picked up, sorted, packed, invoiced, loaded onto the truck and shipped. So this completes the outbound process. Now, if you want to see this in one order, how it happens in the warehouse, this is how it is going to happen. See from your left hand side, that is the shipment is ready. It came into the facility now. That means it has completed the security check. You unload the products, you receive the product, you sort the product depending on which zone into the storage area it has to go. You complete a quality check, you do a put away into the location. Now you receive an order, you process the order. It could be a sales order, delivery order, transfer order. You generate pick tags, pick the product, complete a quality check, sort the products, pack the products, invoice the products, and then you load it onto the truck and you are going to ship it out. This is the end-to-end of the activities which happens inside the warehouse. You may be asking, inventory, what happens? The storage, that will be taken as a separate topic itself. Inventory is like a gold mine of opportunities. How much to store, where to store, how to store, replenishment model, every nuances will be covered part of the session. Inventory, again, this will be part of the same playlist in the channel, Fundamentals of Supply Chain. We will take care of this as a separate series altogether. But this is what happens as an inward and outward within the warehouse. This is the standard, but as I've told, QC, whether it is needed or not, when my product should be available for sale, sorting is required or not, it's case to case basis, okay? But you can have this as kind of a basic understanding of what happens in a warehouse. So that's it on this session. I'm sure today's session is interesting. Warehousing is one of a booming field and one of my personal favorite, I would say, because part of my full-time jobs, I've handled big warehouses up to the size of almost a million square feet under my portfolio out of my country level operations roles. Not just that, I have even designed warehouses of the size of 4 lakh or 5 lakh square feet in one single facility. Very exciting field, both to run it as operation or as a designing as a consultant as well. So I'm sure this would set the stage to start your journey in warehousing. In the coming videos, I will talk more about the warehouse optimization technique as well. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned. I will meet you soon with yet another video on the channel. Thank you so much.